So when you pull an Xbox remote, there's that much
That
travel,
millisecond.
right? So you got to pull back and it goes on a scuff controller. Those clickers, you go,
So it's like a
so it's like a
mouse
mouse
almost.
click. And then there's these paddles down here.
I don't care about any of this.
Well, fuck you, dude. Rad. Hey everybody, that's PC Master Race. That's the Waffles.
Hi.
The Oku Rad.
Benny.
Oh yeah, me. We are told by editor we have to mention our Patreon. We're gonna do this at the beginning of all of these. Patreon.
In a rainbow.
Patreon.
Instagram. So I guess Patreon. On the Patreon you get extra content that you can't normally get. You can show love.
We get it earlier than normies.
What are we doing today?
We react to K-pop.
No, what are we doing?
I know.
NCT! 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 It is a glorious day for me here today at Dioku Rad because we are watching my ultimate K-pop.
127, right?
NCT yeah. 127. So even out of all the subunits of NCT, it's my favorite subunit.
I think you like 127 as well.
You do.
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
Are those the boys in the glass case?
Boss. I mean, that was NCTU.
Right, but the boys in the glass case,
where
an
they
entire
were that was
freaking...
Dream.
Oh, that was Dream, yeah.
That was Dream.
That was, but some crossover.
Whatever,
yeah, he's
bro.
Referring to the NCT Dream movie, which he's still obviously traumatized from. Where the boys were dancing in glass cases
and, like,
and they were just with each other. It was
dancing,
so good. I wouldn't
dancing.
Call it dancing. They were
okay.
Sexing.
Oh, man,
what
that
is
was
it, Benny?
Hard to do.
Is the mind always open?
The mind is
open.
So today's the day.
So a little bit of controversy with this one, which
Ooh,
I think
we
is
love
really,
controversy
it's the dumbest.
Here.
You're not gonna love this one.
We just love a hot take. It's
People
fine.
Are complaining that artwork was too low budget.
What?
People.
It was too simple, too low budget.
Netizens.
Come
fucking
on.
Real.
I just,
relax.
How about
Nobody
this?
Can do anything right
how about,
in K-pop.
How about, I would say, how about this? No artwork.
Yeah,
just
one
a
of these.
Black
just,
screen.
How about no, how about nothing physically that you can hold?
Just digital. Oh,
you just watch it on the computer and then that's what you get. So a long enough timeline, you bitch about something too much, at least in my mom's world. Uh-huh. If I cry or complain about something,
it's gone.
Good. None for you then.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just be happy that they even came out with something new.
Does it all always have to be
no.
bright and colorful?
Maybe they're changing some aspect of what they're doing, or maybe it's whatever.
Or just
no.
doing something different.
Exactly.
You know who is changing things?
Oh, Jesus
so
Christ.
So I will,
anyways,
this because I mentioned this in every NCT ever video. Mark is my bias, and I will be making sure to
So
be
Mark
like
is in 127.
He is.
Okay.
All right.
He's also in Dream.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
And he's been in You a lot. So he's Hei-chan and Mark are both in Dream in 127.
The mind is open.
Yeah.
Yes. That's Mark.
Yep. Yeah. Ooh, it's already sassy. Things will never be the same like.
Ooh, that's kind of weird. In a fun
Ooh,
way.
I don't
Ooh,
like
that
hair.
That's anime hair right there.
Reminds me of Static X.
And that's Hei-chan. He's the next. He's the other one in both. It's up to you what you wanna do.
Anti-drop.
Not quite as
subtle.
Yeah. Because the verses are already pretty quiet.
Yeah.
It's such a cheap trick putting the men in suits.
It's
craving for a change up. 보이지 않는 그 곁들의 무게 절반 남아 내 plan. Are you ready? 불확실한 내일의 태양에 아스라이 스쳐간 사라진 유성에 그 순간도 네가 있으니
straight up Jankos, bro.
Yeah,
Yo.
Hey, I see you. No,
we have really sound switched here.
Yeah.
Tell me, baby.
Ben is like dying and like he hates it. All night long, what? You book it, guys.
He's such a talented rapper.
Actually, they have a lot of talented rappers.
So, wow, abrupt. And that's it. Would you like to just go ahead and get your shitting on it out of the way?
He's shitting on it. I wasn't going to shit on it. The mind is open. It was fine. A little slot machine-y there with that weird break.
So they, but even the, I feel like the verse was pretty different from the chorus even. So it was really one of those. So
and they brought it way down.
I mean, like, I was low, like, low.
Okay.
So I can get...
Which is not normal for 127, right? I mean, I'm sure there's some.
So it's hard with 127 because they are actually really known for having kind of weird songs.
Okay.
Like, Sticker got this a lot, too. A lot of people didn't like Sticker when it first came out. It was because it's one of those songs where you have to listen to it and listen to it to really get it. And I imagine Ayo is going to be a little
similar,
bit like that, too. They just experiment a lot with
sound.
Which
is cool.
It is really cool. But if your ears aren't used to hearing it, it can take a second to be like, what am I hearing here? You know what I mean?
It had like a trip-hop element to it that was in the background. So, and again, though, I can get entirely too analytical about this. And it's not this group in particular, but across the board.
Yeah.
And this is what I was talking about earlier, and nobody wants to take me seriously.
Oh, God.
But... as just a casual watcher and now somewhat better at it, I prefer the more toned down street kind of vibe. And I remember I've said this in the past of certain outfits that were, would you wear that in the street? Well, a lot of this, you would wear it in the street.
Yeah.
And the term idol is you idolize them. You look up to them, you admire them. So the standard for K-pop would be obviously they're performing, right? But you don't walk around dressed that way. Right. So if K-pop is becoming more user friendly and relatable in regards to that, I'm here for it. And I think they show a good example of, to me, how much cooler you look when you're just doing nice choreography and toned down street clothes rather than like looking like
the
not a human.
Well, like
or just like you're wearing platform heels this big and the
spaceship is circling.
And pulled your face like, no, just get out there and show some cool moves and wear some regular gear.
Their choreo was good.
It was great.
Yeah. It was so strong.
But this is the part of the video that I was enjoying the most, was just like they're just in their casual street gear doing some dancing. Awesome.
Kind of XG was kind of like that too.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. If K-pop is going that way.
You like this trend.
Go.
Yeah. But don't you guys
the relatable.
Interesting that like all these groups that are doing that more toned down, stripped down, more relatable thing are also all following that 90s R&B.
Well, of course. But that's what's cool right now. And make no mistake, those baggy jeans are in the mail, dude.
Kill me.
Sorry.
I'd rather die. You can't pry my skinnies out of my cold dead hands.
It's happening. It's going to happen. Jankos.
I'm not wearing them.
Oh, it's going to happen. This girl. You don't have to wear them, but they're there. It's going to be.
Well, they're already here, obviously.
Well, it's.
Yeah, I have plans to wear them.
It's going to the streets, homie.
Right.
That's everybody's going to be rocking.
But
NCT is one of those really progressive K-pop.
That's fine. And they did a good job. I'm not.
No. I'm not like trying to argue with what your assessment.
Don't argue with me.
Well, they've been around.
Can you shut the fuck up?
I'll let them do that. They've been around for a minute too, right?
A long time.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So they're kind of like a staple. Yeah.
And, you know, with Mark and Haechan, and actually all the boys, when you think about it, because you was a rotating subunit. They are kind of well versed across all genres. Like they've done it all.
I'm super stoked the internet just saw how quickly I can jerk a chain.
So I think that this is like really in line with what they're doing. Like they're following that. But so, and the 90s thing is not new to NCT.
No, but yeah, I don't think it's new to K-pop as a whole. It's been coming.
No, but I'm saying like, because you know we'd like try to credit New Jeans sort of.
Yeah.
Which well, they no, did. They kind
of, yeah, to my but attention,
NCT
yes.
NCT 127.
No, you're right. It's the summer
has
of the,
done it.
It's the summer of the furry backpack. Here it comes.
Oh, I'm okay with that. I wanted one so bad. I never got one. Thanks, Mom.
White belt, furry backpack, baggy clothes.
Low rise jeans. No, thanks.
But here's what I'm saying. I didn't hate it. I'll give it an 8.6. And that's pretty high.
Oh, that is high.
The reason I'm doing it is because, and actually this is a really good example in my brain. They're actually starting to straddle, to me, just stick with the cool street stuff, and they're still wanting or... whoever is handling them is still wanting them to do a video where they're dancing in like a tube. But you can also see where it's like, you know, it's way cooler. So what do you like? Right? You got the video that the band puts out and then dance practice.
I love the dance practice.
Yes. Everybody loves the dance practice because that's real.
Right.
So watching
and you see
them,
their talent.
Watching them, yeah, do like their choreography on Jupiter doesn't, it's fine.
It's distracting.
It's, it takes but away but from the show us the idols. And now they're starting to do that.
What
and
I will
that's
say,
what's
though,
happening.
Is I think a lot of people like the over-the-top, loud,
they
horrible
do. Yes.
K-pop.
Go see them live, then.
Well, that's I'm not giving
saying,
you a video. That's not giving
the other
dancers
part,
a
you know what? Now that I think about it, the other part, when the K-pop group I've seen live, they devoted a lot of time to just being real. They weren't really even performing. They're just hanging out talking to you.
Right. Which I could have done a little
just hang out and talk.
Yeah. You don't need to like go so late.
New Jeans is a revolution.
Oh, my God. Oh boy. On that, I'm going to do, 8.7. I liked it.
So I'm actually probably a 7.5 on that one.
Oh.
But
musically.
Because, yes, musically, visually, there's no.
Literally.
And that was an NCT 127 stan.
And I'm a huge stan, but I know how I am with NCT 127, and I know with their experimental sound, I don't always immediately
it.
Gravitate
it. Sounded like
it.
Trip hop to me.
I think it was just so disjointed
it's
that it
trip-hop.
Was a little...
Well, trip-hop is a little disjointed.
Yeah, but I mean, like, particularly when Katie was talking about the bridge, where they just, I mean, they were on a different plane.
They put
like,
it 1 centimeter from the ground.
But I still liked it.
Right.
It's just putting it together and making it make sense, which it will eventually. I just need to give it a few more lessons, and then my 7.5 will skyrocket, I'm sure. Like it always does with NCT.
I don't think we need tomorrow. I think everybody knows what happened here.
Yes.
Don't we?
All right, guys. Well... thanks for watching. Bye.
Patreon. Deo-oku. Rad.